The Art by Marlene 4 collection was released in September, and now that the initial rush is over, I'm going to take a little time to explore what was included. In today's 5 Minutes of Fun video, I'll test and play with some of the stamps, the rice papers, and those sweet little journals. We're going to begin our 5 minutes today with the two journals in the collection for release. There's this one that measures 6 by 8 1/4, and then this adorable little one that is 4 by 4. They both include 15 sheets of 300 GSM watercolor paper, and it's nice and sturdy so that you can see that despite the fact that this page has been wet and dried on both sides, while it's not perfectly flat, the amount of movement that you've seen from the paper is not unacceptable anyway. And I think that this is just awesome. This little journal is so cute. Easily fits both of these actually in a purse or a tote bag if you want to take them with you. I like this size particularly because it's easy to get something done from start to finish in maybe a 20-minute setting or sitting if that's all you have available. All right, so let's turn our attention now to the rice papers. There are 6 in this release, and this is a brand new product for Marlene. She's done a really nice job with them. 3 of them are completely full color. Everything is based on her drawings and her journal pages, and 3 of them are black and white. Now, here's a couple of interesting things about this. When you have any place you see white on here, when you apply this by putting gel medium on your surface and then gel medium on top once you place it, anything that's white is pretty much going to vanish or close to vanish. So for example, if you look at this page here, so this is a page that all I did was I used one of the dilutions colors. I wet the page, put a little bit of color on there and let it move. And yes, there is stickles in the background because they make me happy. But if you look really closely here at the antenna, if you look really closely, you can just barely see the background is there. Well, who wants to cut those out? They're so tiny. And realistically, could you actually effectively cut them out? Probably not. And so it's a good thing that that white background disappears. It means that you don't have to be quite so precise. Or if you don't want to lose a real fine detail like that, you don't actually have to. So where this might make a bit of a difference for you, however, is if you're working with something like I did here. So this is one of the leaves from this sheet that has the flowers and the stems and the leaves on it. Now this background is fairly dark in places, and what I didn't want was for the color to get lost, or the pattern in color on this leaf to get lost in the background. So again, coming here, you can see where this piece, when it went on, and for a second, it just ignoring the stickles on there, you can see the background through there. Well, I didn't want that to happen here, so what I did instead was I just took that shape and I glued it on a piece of 90-pound watercolor paper, then I cut it out, and now I don't have to worry about the background interfering with that pattern. So I think that that's a really good thing. So let me show you how I apply these. We're going to talk about stamps in the next segment, but this bloody adorable little dog is going to go there, and I'm actually going to put this piece right here. So you can see that this white looks pretty white, but the minute I put gel medium on there, it's not going to. So I'm just going to, this is an old ratty brush that I use for just for things like this. I'm going to put the gel medium down roughly where I want this piece to be, and here's where the magic is going to happen. As I apply the gel medium to the top of this, you're going to see that white kind of go away. It's a little less obvious on this one, but you see that white almost completely vanish, and now I can see the background through there. So that's it. It's just a question of letting this dry. Let me just put that in some water. Letting this dry so that I can come back and then just trim the edge here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to glue this dog on. Now ordinarily I would not, well, it's fine. Ordinarily, I'm not going to use gel medium on this. It just doesn't have enough, unless I was using the ultra thick, it doesn't have enough oomph to do what I want it to. So instead, I'm going to bring in some of the Scotch Quick Dry, and I'm just going to put some of that on the back of this dog. And as I said, we'll talk about this silly little dog in the next segment when we talk about the stamps. So this is what you see on this bottle is one of our fine tip applicators. This allows me to get the glue to come out in a nice small bead so that I can control it a little bit better. All right, that looks good enough. Now I am, because this glue, it does dry clear, but it also will dry shiny. So what I will do is once I get this down, I'm gonna grab a piece of paper towel and I'm gonna use it to just mop up any glue that seeps out from the edges. With that fine tip applicator, it doesn't actually happen all that often because I'm much more careful and I'm much more precise when I put glue on that way. All right, so there we go. How adorable is that dog? I think it is so darn cute. And again, I'm gonna show this to you in the next segment, how you can work, and I'm gonna quickly show you how you can kind of get this watercolor effect when you use a water brush in pretty much any liquid medium. This release includes 6 clear stamp sets numbered from 39 to 44. I have not used elements from these 3, but I did want to show them to you. Let's move those out of the way. So if I bring in the larger of the 2 journals, you can see I have the dog here, which is from, this is set 40. So it includes the dog and this, whatever it is with the octopus on its head, a bunny and a couple of other little elements. And then on the back side here, I used the llama, which is from set 39. You can see there's the llama, My Little Pony clone or a unicorn clone, a dachshund, and a couple of other bits. And then from this set, I'm actually going to watercolor these 2 flowers. I'm going to show you that technique. So I have a piece of 90-pound cold-pressed watercolor paper. I like this weight because it's sturdy enough that I can watercolor it and it's not going to warp. But happily, it's much easier to cut than 140 pounds, so it's better when it comes to that. So I have some of the new Dilutions spray stains here. I have, well, that's Fiery Sunset. I don't think I'm going to use that one. I have Pink Flamingo. This is Blue Lagoon and Island Paris. So when I do this, I mean, you could certainly put these colors in water brushes, and I have a whole set of them someplace, but for this little bit, I'm actually not going to drag them out. I don't need to. So I'm just going to put a little bit of color here on my surface, and then I'm just going to pick it up with the water brush. This will be more than enough to do what I need to. I like a reasonably fine water brush. Even though this tip looks pretty big, it comes to a nice point, so it's not going to give me more area than I have to deal with. I might ordinarily do a little bit of shading, but these elements are so small, I'm probably not going to. So this is Island Parrot. It's a nice green color, kind of a grass green color. If I had a larger area, I might bring in some of the new color, the other new color. This is a really deep color that's named Balmy Night. I might use that as a little bit, or I could pick one of the other greens. But honestly, you know what? Maybe I could actually squeeze a little bit in here. Honestly, there's not a whole lot of shading that you can do here. But what I can do instead, so let's wipe this up. Now, this is a really, really deep color. But what I'll do is just put a little tiny bit there. Alrighty, that's probably enough. Honestly, it's so deep. So I'm going to just clean the color, the green that's in there, out, and I'm going to pick up a tiny bit of this. And it is so dark that I probably don't want any more than that. And then, well, I missed there with the green, so maybe I can use a little bit more. So I'm just going to come and darken the inner one here. And honestly, this is not fine art that I'm trying to create. I want to give these a colored look so that they're kind of interesting, and then I'm ready to put them on my page. So if I were going to do the center, let's do the center of the one with the heart in the middle. I'm going to put down, this is just a little bit of tattered, not tattered rose, duh, this is a little bit of scattered straw. Now the nice thing about a water brush like this is because there's water in the reservoir, I can dilute this if I think that it's going to be a little bit too dark by thinning it with the water, but in this case I don't really need to. Now I'm going to hold off doing this heart simply because the area around it is wet, and if I'm not careful I could get some of the red or pink in there and it would end up wicking out. But you see that this is the process. Really, really easy to do. I'm just going to pick up one more red and I'll work on that heart a little bit. But then I mean we're supposed to be here in 5 minutes, and I have the feeling I've probably run over a little bit, but hopefully you will persevere and watch through to the end with me. All right, so good enough. That is so simple. That's how I go ahead and do this kind of coloring. So then the last elements to talk about are the 3 dyes. Now, I have not had an opportunity to work with these, but there are 3 shapes. So there's the squares, the circles and this big flower that kind of reminds me of a mum. I have, as I said, not had an opportunity to use these, but in looking at some of the examples that I saw from Marlene, what she does is, especially these two, she'll cut them out and then use fragments of them that are different colored as background elements, which I think is great. I also saw her use the big flower as kind of an overlay. Again, another really good idea. So we are out of time. I'm not going to do any more today. I hope you have enjoyed seeing this Art by Marlene collection for release.